Today we're at Stirling University. The last couple of times, you know, we've been in Edinburgh, we've been in Paisley. Obviously, you know, the last video, the Edinburgh one, it's all, you know, learning and getting through the process. There's a couple of things, you know, that when I look back, you know, maybe I shouldn't have said, but in the spur of the moment, you say certain things, you know, maybe change your tactic a wee bit. But as I say again, you know, we're here at Stirling University, and we're just going to do the same. We're going to ask people some questions just to see what kind of awareness they have, and obviously, you know, ask them about the practical examples. And again, we can see here, there's a perfectly good example here of a large pond, which is just a smaller version of an ocean. You know, so we've got a good reference point. So hopefully, we're going to get some good students that will go on and talk to us. Peace. Yeah, another important point that I want to make is, you know, we're saying to people flat earth, people need to be aware that nobody at this channel represents any flat earth map or model. The reality of the situation is the common man like us don't know really where we are. So I just wanted to put that in there just so that people really know. There's no point in, you know, employing logical fallacy and asking people to answer questions based on a model that none of us represent. We want to bring awareness to people about the global eye, and also to push the message that we need the full exploration in order to discover the full dimensions.
Fraser,
how you doing? I'm Dale Fraser.
How you doing, Dale?
Oh, didn't you play golf, Fraser?
No, my brother does.
You don't play golf, right, so I'll not go with that angle then. I'll just get straight in here, right?
Right.
Do you believe you live on a globe?
Yes.
You do?
Uh-huh.
Can I ask you why?
Science kind of proves that.
Well, this is the thing, but I should have said this before I started. I love science.
Right.
And I'm a natural science guy. Do you know what natural science is?
Not exactly.
Natural science is basically observing the world, you know.
Right.
And, you know, science like that should be based on empirical proof, which is testing, observing, repeating,
mm-hmm.
so that we come to understandings about reality and stuff like that. So you were saying you believed you lived on a globe.
Yes,
but
aye.
Do you know why?
Well, there's scientific measurement. We've been in space, we can actually observe that.
You've been to space?
I've not been to space, no.
Do you think those images that you see are actual photographs?
Yes.
You do?
Aye.
Although they tell you on the NASA site they're not.
Do they?
Yes.
Right, okay.
Here's the thing, NASA knew our
site. So can I just ask you a question? Do you think it's flat?
Well, can I get, I'm just going to get to you in a wee minute.
Right, right, okay.
I'll make a couple of points first, right. NASA are saying now that they're trying to achieve the beyond low Earth orbit.
Right.
Right, because there's an issue, they say, with a thing called the Van Allen radiation belts,
right.
which is a band of radiation that stretches for 25,000 miles extending out from the globe, if
right.
you believe you live on a globe. So, based on that, you know, they say they went to the moon in the 1960s.
Uh-huh.
Do you think they did?
That's open for debate, I don't know. Political hot potato there.
Yes. But if NASA are now saying they can't achieve beyond low Earth orbit with all the modern technologies and stuff, then that would suggest to me that there was absolutely no chance that they went to the moon. So here's a couple of points. You said you were an electrician, am I correct?
Uh-huh.
So you're kind of mechanically minded,
yes,
and stuff.
And
so as I say, I'll go back to it again, natural science is testing, observing, repeating.
Mm-hmm.
That's how we find out what reality is. So you know they tell you that space is a vacuum,
mm-hmm.
and that we live in an atmosphere, a positive pressure system.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So I can say there's a negative pressure system and a positive pressure system. Now, in reality, two opposing pressure systems 100% of the time require a solid separation.
Mm-hmm.
Do you agree with that?
Mm-hmm. Go yep. along with that, eh?
Yep, because that's reality and that's what was there. So why would you then believe that it was different on a larger scale?
What was it? In what sense?
Well, they're telling you that there's a vacuum up there,
right.
and that we are in a pressurised system and there's no solid barrier between the two of them.
But is it not the atmosphere?
well, the atmosphere is what we're living in right now.
Yeah.
So it's a gas, it's air, it's all these things. It's a different pressure from a vacuum.
So what are your suggestions up there then?
I'm just, all I'm saying is pointing out the contradictions of what we test in reality. Mm-hmm. For me, if somebody claims there's another medium up there, there has to be a solid barrier. That's based on natural science. So I'll go to my next point. Could you give me, because you're mechanically minded, right?
Oh, no.
Could you give me one practical example, just one, right, of a body of water conforming to the exterior of a shape?
A body of water conforming to the exterior of a shape? Well, sure, if it was in a tank.
Yeah, but it's taking the form of the tank.
Ah, that's something.
So if I say this to you, bodies of water must be contained, they will take the shape of their container.
Right, yeah.
You understand, right? The body of water, the pond over there, the surface is always flat.
Aye, and whatever's underneath is whatever's underneath.
Yep, but from one end of the pond to the other, or any body of water, will be at the same level. If or no, the water will start to flow.
Flow, that's right.
Right, so you understand that, right? Uh-huh. So they say that the Earth's 80% covered in water.
Right.
We know how water behaves.
Yep.
So how can we be living on a globe?
Atmospheric pressure, I'm guessing here. I don't know.
But natural science again, can you give me a practical example?
Well, water is, the seas are fairly stable and level apart from the tides, yep, which the moon controls, so that's where the tides go up and down.
I'm going to have to push you for proof if you say stuff like that to me.
Well, I've seen the tide go up and down.
You've seen the tide go up and down?
Aye.
But the only reason you think that it's the moon that's there is because that's what they told you.
Yes, aye.
Right, so, but there's absolutely zero proof for that. There's so many contradictions against it. I'm not going to go into that just now because I don't want to keep you. I know you're a busy man. But, you know, as I say to you at the start, natural science, real science, is testable, observable, repeatable. All claims must match that criteria, or they're no reality. Can you produce one practical example of a body of water conforming to the exterior of a shape?
I don't really understand that question. I'm not
a globe is round, and the water's conforming to the outside of the sphere.
Yeah, but I mean, it's because it's on such a large scale. I mean, it's,
if I took a shape, a square, a triangle, a pyramid, and I tried to get a body of water to cling to it, run the outside of it, we know that's no reality.
It's not going to happen, no.
Right, so that's what I'm saying to you.
If
it's not testable, repeatable, observable, how is it reality?
But surely our atmosphere keeps it in here.
What do you mean?
Well, just that. Like, I mean, I don't know the science yet, I've not started yet.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Well, this is what we're trying to kind of, you know, spark critical thought and common sense in people.
Right, well, I'll look into this.
Aye,
there's no doubt about that.
Aye, definitely. And this is the other thing, you know, there is absolutely zero proof for a globe.
Right.
There's absolutely.
You can actually see the curvature of the Earth in places.
No, you can't.
No,
mate. If you go up, doesn't matter how high you go, the horizon will be flat and parallel with your eyes. It'll be eye level with you. Doesn't matter how high you go.
Right, so explain to me then, how would you, right, say you started at point A anywhere in the globe and you went all the way around it,
yeah,
and you came back to the same place.
Right.
Right, so how's that work?
Did you do that?
My dad's done his universe in the area, he's
told
just done that.
But this is how easy it is, right? And I'm going to show you
fall
right
off
now.
The end of the Earth.
Right now I'm in the UK, right? And I'm going to go around the world, you watching? Stay there. Here I'm back again. Is the pavement a round ball?
I can't see for the sun, like, just
is the pavement a round ball?
No.
So do you understand how you could go around the world like that then?
No.
Well, see that big pond there?
Uh-huh.
See, if I was to go there and I was to put seven continents in it?
Yep.
Right? That would be an accurate representation of the reality we actually live in.
But surely if you went in a straight line from point A and then came back to point A again?
A perfectly straight line?
Yeah, well, as straight as you could do, right, you know, being practical.
But that's hearsay, you know?
How is it hearsay?
Because you've never done it.
Well, I've never done it.
But you know, you say your dad's been round the world. I know people have been round the world, but they didn't go in a perfectly straight line.
No, possibly not. Like, I mean, that's probably practically impossible.
So what we're trying to point out is just how, you know, they say these things to you and they push
as if,
you know, because if I went running a flat plane,
mm-hmm,
I could still say, oh, but running the ball, you know, there's nothing any different. What we're looking for is actual proofs that it is a globe.
Right.
So we ask people if they can just give us one proof that it is a globe.
Off the top of my head, no.
Right.
Just other than what I've been told and what I believe and what I've read,
yep,
and people's experiences.
Yeah. So would you say then it's because of what you were told? Then,
yes.
You know, that's perfect. That's exactly what we're looking for.
Aye.
But you know what we're trying to show people is that when you actually look for proof, guys like us, we were the same. We believed we lived in a globe through childhood, all the way up until you actually, you know, applied natural science and you actually looked for real proofs, and there's none.
Right.
Everything tells us that it's stationary and flat.
Right,
and where's the proof for this?
I just don't understand how you can think Like, that's like going back to like the 15, 1600s when they thought they were going to fall off the end of the earth.
But that's what they told you. They told you that there was an edge.
What are you suggesting is there if it isn't?
Nobody knows.
Right.
Because there's a thing called the Antarctic Treaty in Antarctica.
Mm-hmm.
Where I think it's 47, don't quote me on that.
Yeah.
47 nations, right,
uh-huh,
work in unison in order to protect Antarctica. Now, in the middle, they're all at war with each other. Right, but in Antarctica, many people suggest and many people think, I'm no one of these that's included, by the way, that Antarctica is actually all the way round the outside is. What's never been done is north to south circumnavigation. It's probably impossible.
Practically
possible and physically probably impossible, you know. Because for me, you know,
you can fly though.
It's not a globe.
You can fly.
You could fly, you'd think you would, and you'd think we'd have all these vast, you know, varying pictures and stuff. But I'll go back to it again, you know, you go to NASA's website,
mm-hmm,
they'll tell you that all the images you're seeing there are composites.
Mm-hmm.
They're composite images, they're no actual photographs. Because, you know, you kinda get out.
I thought you could see the curvature of the earth when Concorde was flying.
Yeah.
Do you know that for a fact?
Well, I know for a fact there's people put balloons up. And there's one I could show you right now at 121,000 feet.
Mm-hmm.
The horizon's at eye level, as flat as a fucking pancake. And if you're on a sphere, right, if you're on the top of a sphere, you start to rise up for the sphere. 360 degrees round you, the horizon would start to drop. So the higher you go, you would start looking down at the horizon.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're on a sphere. That's not reality. When you go on a plane and the higher it goes up, the horizon keeps rising to your eye level.
Right, we'll see on ships, right, you get VHF radio, and that's point to point. Like, you know, you can only transmit and receive what you can actually sort of physically see.
Yeah.
Right, and then because if a ship goes over the horizon, right, that means it's gone over the curve.
So
and
they
then,
told you.
Well, I've seen it because like, I used to work on ships, like,
yep,
and
so
like, you've got to use MF and HF so you can transmit and receive.
Yeah.
Because but you can't
those
see.
Those waves are parallel waves. They go parallel and come back parallel. You know, we were told that the ships go over the curvature of the earth, but now we've got modern video equipment. We've got things with super zooms on them. So, and there's many, many videos, go and check out yourself.
Do,
so, because this is how our eyes work, there's a convergence point, and we've got a perspective. The floor rises, the sky comes down, and the sides meet in. Like if you were looking along a rail track, you know, they start to narrow.
Yeah.
Then there's a point where it converges and it vanishes.
Right,
that's what happens with ships. Now, if you can wait until the ship is totally gone,
mm-hmm,
well out of sight, you can't see it, you can pull one of these cameras up, zoom right in and bring the thing back into full view again. Right, it's so
important. Can I see this?
YouTube, somewhere? Anywhere you like. P900 Super Zoom. There's loads of guys doing it. They show you the effects, the same effects looking over the salt flats and stuff. Where you can create the same, you know, things disappearing that are not disappearing. It's how our eyes work.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just like we've got so much moisture in there. Like right now, you look across here, things are coming down to the floor, the sky's coming down, you can see, you know, things get smaller. Right? That's just how our eyes. Every artist paints a flat horizon,
mm-hmm,
you understand perspective. But they tell you that it's going over a body of water, right, over the curvature. Now, here's the ridiculous thing, right? If you're standing here and the ground starts to slope away from you over there,
mm-hmm,
right, and I pour water on the ground, what's going to happen to the water?
It's going to run down that way.
Of course it is.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So, I'll try and find you. So, you know, this is what they're saying to you. If you're standing watching a ship going over the curvature, this is where the contradictions come in. Obviously, we know bodies of water lie flat, so it's not happening, right? That's
mm-hmm,
not it. But they try and use an optical thing to tell you that's what's happening. Now, they're saying to you that's happening between 3 and 12 miles,
mm-hmm,
right? Now, you can see, right, fine, well, this ship's going over the horizon at 3 to 12 miles, but here's the problem. I can see from left to right up to 100 miles unobstructed in my view. Absolutely no curvature there. So do you not think it's a wee bit of a contradiction? If you see a ship going over the curve that way,
mm-hmm,
at 12 miles, we'll say gear in the maximum, but you can see 80 to 100 miles left to right with absolutely no zero curvature, that would tell me that you lived on a cylinder.
You live in a cylinder, is that where we're coming?
Well, you would have to be. If things are curving that way, but no this way, you'd have to be living on a cylinder.
Right. So right. What happens at the edge of, at the end of this, is it a...
No, I'm just saying hypothetically.
Right.
It would have to be if right. You go by what they're saying, because there's so many contradictions,
mm-hmm,
as I've just pointed out. Well, you can't have... One eyeball curvature should be going every direction. So you can't see all the ships disappearing at 12 miles straight in front of me, but from left to right I can see 100 miles, it's not curving.
See, I don't know, is that a fact?
Well, you'll start looking at
it. I will.
Is the whole point of we're trying to bring people awareness to. Don't listen to these peaceful scientists, guys. Use your common sense, your senses. Do you trust your senses? Of course you do, right? So, as I say to you, your common sense tells you water must be contained, it lies flat, the horizon's always flat, everywhere is flat, but you've to ignore that in favour of what these priests tell you, that it's a globe.
Is there? Right? Well, so,
you should, I really hope you do, man.
So natural science?
Natural science, you know, basically natural science for me is everything that's to be repeated. That's how we go on in life, you know. How do they mean in construction? They use spirit levels. Why?
So you can get it straight. Can't use one on a ship though.
Aye, but why would they use them? What is it that the nose level? On a spirit level?
Aye, you're just going level to whatever the base they've used.
Yeah.
It's not level.
What's in the spirit level?
Can't remember.
Water.
Aye, but I think it's just straight water.
What did we use before the spirit levels?
Was it mercury or something?
Water.
Was it then?
See, if I had a big hole somewhere and I wanted to find out if it was level,
mm-hmm.
I'd fill it with water. It's the most accurate measuring tool we have. If you used a laser's fine in smoke and, you know, and a house and stuff. As soon as you go to a big environment, if I was to measure across there, the laser would start getting sprayed everywhere because it's affected by the moisture in the air. You know, refraction, diffraction, reflection and stuff. So water's more accurate.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the thing, you know, the place is 80% covered in water. That tells me beyond any shadow of a doubt it ain't no fucking globe.
Right.
Yeah.
But I'm going to look into this and I'm really interested.
I mean,
I just want to know, what do you think is it?
Well, right now, you know, on my channel, we don't claim any map or model through. As I say, you get the agencies who try and, you know, because there's a lot of attention on this, because obviously it's a huge secret. So they try and, push these maps and models and then try and get you to adopt them so they can attack it, because there's flaws in it. So what I would suggest to you is what if you get into this, don't listen to the end of it telling you this is what the flat earth is, this is what it looks like, because it's all bollocks. Right? We don't know what it is. Our stance is, we know beyond a shadow of a doubt that it's not a globe,
mm-hmm.
but what we need now is full exploration. We need the world awake to it, and we need all the militaries in the world exploring in order to find exactly what the full dimensions are, because it's being hidden for us right now. There's a possibility that there's other ponds like yours beyond, and there's other life in them.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So, you know, they're no getting out up there. They want us looking up there all the time. And as I say to you, when you go and look at these videos of the super zoom, they're the same for stars. You see what the stars really look like, because they don't look like what NASA showed you. Neither do the planets. They're no solid-bodied things, right?
Mm-hmm.
They're luminaries. They're like...
light.
They're like morphing plasmic energy. When you actually see them, it's quite awe-inspiring. I mean, it takes your breath away. The first time I seen it, I'm like, wow,
mm-hmm.
that's what they really look like. Then you go and look at these images, NASA, and these places show you, that's not what they look like.
Right, so, I'll look into this.
Nice one, man.
Interesting.
Appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Okay, dokie.